Hey everyone, it's Jeff from Crowded Learning, and in this video I am going to show you how to organize the lessons and activities that you have put into a skill block that you have created. Now in the previous lesson, we created our very first skill block on multiplication, and that skill block has 17 free and open educational resources or activities that align to the skill that I want. So I am going to click on multiplication, my skill block here, and it's going to open up where we left off. Now, when you first create a skill block, all of the resources are going to be listed in order based on the creator or the source of that resource. And so I've done some rearranging here, but when we first created this, we had all the Khan Academy resources and its interactive practice activities from Khan Academy. Then we had all the Math is Fun resources, which includes lessons, games, and other things. And then we had the FET resource at the bottom. Now I've taken some time to look at these various resources and evaluate them a little bit to see what order do I want them in the case that I'm actually going to share this skill block with students. So I've decided that I'm actually going to focus just on single digit multiplication and single digit times 10 times 100 times 1000. So this one, I'm going to rename it, and we're going to we'll call it single digit multiplication, and then I'll ultimately create another skill block that focuses on two digit multiplication. So the rearranging that I've done of these resources is in an order that makes sense for me, I'm thinking, if I was going to share this with my students. And all I have to do that is to click on this little hamburger menu here, and it allows me to rearrange these things in order. Now, in terms of how I evaluated each of these resources, now that they're in here, I have the ability to click on all of these and launch the particular resource. So as I said, FET is a set of simulations, and in this case, this is a really great activity in the Explorer that allows me to move this around and see the connections between area models and multiplication facts. So this is something that you can use for students to self-explore and share with you some of the things that they observed, or you can create activities using FET that are more guided. But the order that I've created this is having that sort of simulation to have students explore the concept up front. And then we have a lesson from Math is Fun on multiplication tips and tricks. So this is a set of guides that helps people understand what the multiplication table looks like, and then gives some basic sort of factor tricks in terms of understanding how to start learning your multiplication tables. So I like that activity. And then there's also a multiplication trainer game. And so this is actually a game that I can use for a bunch of different things, but it's already set to multiply, but there's also other operations. And I can select the specific type of thing that I want to focus on, and I can set the number of minutes that I want to practice with this game. So that's a great resource for playing around and learning my multiplication facts. And then I've pulled together all of the Khan Academy interactive practice sets that deal with just single digit multiplication, as well as single digits times 10 times 100 times 1000. So all of the other activities are now at the bottom here. So what do I do with those? I could leave them in here and maybe say, hey, students who want to go on and focus on something more advanced, have at it. Or I could, you know, deselect this, and this is just an indication to the student if you want to use it as such, as things that are required and not required. Or I can remove them from this skill block. All I need to do in order to do that is go back to select learning activities, excuse me, and then deselect the ones that I've decided not to use for this particular activity. And so the printable one, while it's great, it really isn't all that useful for a student that probably doesn't have a printer. Long multiplication was one that I didn't want to include. We're going to remove this one as well because it gets into two-digit numbers. And then of the Khan Academy, we're not doing regrouping. That's going to be in my two-digit multiplication lesson. I'm not going to do this. We are keeping the place value one because that's important. We're not using this, and we're just going to have not using the two-digit numbers. And so now I've removed all of those. I'm down to 9 activities within that skill block. I click Save. And so now we have all of the resources that I want. Whoops, I forgot to remove this one. So I'll just go back. And I'm going to remove the two-digit number with area models. And now I'm going to save this again. And now I have this nice consolidated skill block that has the lessons that I want that focus just on single-digit multiplication in the order that I want. And so now this is ready for me to share with students, which is what we will look at in the next video.